I am Santosh Gadinkar. Today's concept is about balancing of rotating masses on several planes. This is the problem, and today I am solving the analytical method of balancing of rotating masses. The particulars of system of revolving masses are attached to the shaft are given below. These are the chart is given: plane, mass, radius, distance, angle of position. These are the four planes are given. Masses are given, radius are given, distance is given, angular position is given. Now find the magnitude and angular position of the two masses. We have to find out the magnitude as well as the angular position of balancing of two balancing masses revolving of 50 mm radius in the plane L and M. First, between A and B, 30 mm from A, and second between C and D, 70 mm from C. First, we have to draw this diagram. Four plane, 1, 2, 3, 4. There are four plane. I will consider roughly here because it is analytical method. Now, this is the A, B, C and D. Now distance from, this is the distance they have given it here. Distance from A to B is 65 mm. Sorry, this is the B, 65 mm from this to this. 65 mm. Now from A to C, 160. A to C, 160 mm. From A to C, okay. AB is 65 mm. AC is 160 mm. And next, from A to D, 8. A to D is 240 mm. The masses are given. Now here the condition is given that 50 mm radius are given. There are the two plane L and M. The first plane is located between A and B. A and B. This L is located between A and B, and a distance of A to L will be 30 mm. Similarly, one more plane lies between C and D here at a distance of 70 mm from C. First part is completed here. Next part, we have to go for angular position of the masses. Second diagram. Angular position of masses. Required a rough diagram. And this name is arrangement of masses. Or arrangement of the plane. You can count as the arrangement of masses or arrangement of planes. Plane or masses. No problem. Plane. Now we are focusing about the angular position of the masses. First one. Zero. The radius is given as what? The radius is 40 mm. This I will consider is the R1, or write it as a 40 mm. No problem. And next is about B is nothing but 65 degree. B is 65 degree. Sorry, where is the angle? Okay, this is the angle they have given it. B is 60 degree. A rough diagram for the B. 60 degree. The masses are there here. This is 12. The mass will be here 10. Next is about C is nothing but 135. 135 roughly here. 135. The mass will be 18 kg. Next is 270. The mass will be 15 kg. Now we have to find out the two angular positions as per the question and magnitude. Okay, this is the important part here. First, the arrangement of the plane or arrangement of the masses. Next, the angular position of the masses in a rough way. This is the first part we have completed now. Next, we have to go for table. Next part. I will keep this paper aside. Next, you have to go for a table. Table. Here first you have to write as a plane plane may be A, next is the L, next is B, next is C. One more here, just I left one more plane here in this diagram. This is the M plane, lies between C and D. M and D. Next, we have to write as a mass. Mass, you can take capital M or small m as in kg. For A mass, it is 12 kg. This is the mass is unknown, therefore I will write as ml. Here the mass will be 10 because everything is given in this 10, mass 10. C will be 18. We don't know the mass of this one, mm. Next, 30 kg. Next we go for radius. In terms of smaller meter, you have to convert into meter. 40 means 0.04. Here they are given at 0.05. The radius is given here. The problem: 50 mm radius in the plane L and M. They are given in the problem 50 mm radius in plane L and M. The radius is given here. Next, for 10, 0.05, 18, 0.06, because we are converting in terms of meter. Here, 0.05, last one, 0.03. Now this part is completed. Next, go for force is nothing but m into r, kg meter. Just multiply these two terms. If you multiply these two terms, the value will be 0.48. Next value will be 0.05 ml. Next, 0.5. Next, 1.08. This value 0.05 mm, and this value 0.45. Just multiply these two terms, mass and radius, you will get the force. Next, distance from the reference plane. I will consider the reference plane, this one as a reference plane. L is the reference plane. Either you can go for M as a reference plane. Distance from a reference plane, I will consider as a small L. Now, as per this diagram, this side we will take as a negative value and this side we will take as a positive value. This is the procedure of several masses. This side from the L I will take as a negative and from this side I will take as a positive value. Now, from the L to A it will be 30 mm, that means minus 0.30. Next, ML will be 0 because in the L 100 H should be 0. Next, this value L to B will be 0.035. L to C 0.130. L to M 0.200. From this part, L to M. Okay. Next, L to D 0.210. This complete the distance from the reference plane L. Now go for couple. Couple is nothing but formula M R L unit kg meter square. That's it. Just multiply this term. You have to multiply M R and L. You will get the couple. For this one, first value will be -0.0148. Here value will be 0. This value will be 0.0175. This value will be 0.1404. This value will be 0.01 mm. And this will be 0.0945. Next, go for theta, finding the angle. I will write directly theta here. Theta for A plane will be 0. For this plane, we have to find out theta L. For this plane, it is given 60 degree. For this plane, it is given as 135. This plane, we have to find out theta M. For this plane, 270. It is given in the data. Theta angles. Theta angles are nothing but these angles, they have mentioned it. Okay. Now, in the analytical one, first one, resolving the, we have to resolve. I'll just try my level best to zoom it out properly. Resolving the moment or couple horizontally and vertically. We have to resolve the forces now. Formula, summation of MH, or MH is nothing but, or you can write as CH or MH. Instead of couple, you can write as a moment, no problem. One and same. I have taken as a mh, that is the nothing but the couple, or you can write as summation of ch. One and same. The formula will be for summation of m rl cos theta. This is the first formula. Now this is nothing but the couple formula, mrl. It is similar to the mrl. Just substitute these values here. First value is minus 0.0148 cos 0, angle will be 0 here. Next, plus 0 cos theta l, definitely if it will be 0 multiplied with this one is nothing but 0. Next, plus 0.0175 cos 60 plus 0.1407 cos 135 plus 0.01 mm cos theta m plus 0.0945 cos 270 to 0. Now calculate this value, and this will be remain unknown term here. 0.0 mm cos theta m. We are going to calculate now with the help of a calculator. Minus, I have already calculated, I will write directly here this value. The value will be minus 0.10492 is equal to 0. Bring this side, 0.001, it should be 1, sorry, 1 cos theta m, it goes this side, 0.10492, equation 1, called as the equation 1. Next, vertical forces, summation of m rl, instead of cos theta you write out, you have to write sin theta, that's it. And replace in the calculator cos term into by means of sin theta, you will get answer directly. No need to go for writing each and every term here. Minus 0.0148 sin 0, 0 sin theta l plus 0.0175 sin 60 plus 0.1404 sin 135 plus 0.01 mm cos theta, sorry, sin theta m plus 0.0945 sin 270 is equal to 0. Answer for this one is nothing but 0.01 mm sin theta m plus 0.0199 is equal to 0. Cross multiply mm sin theta m minus 0.0199, equation 2. Now divide equation 2 by 1. 2 divided by 1, it becomes what? 0.01 mm sin theta m divided by 0.01 mm cos theta m is equal to 0.0199 divided by 0.10492. This time I cancel, it become tan theta. Tan theta m into minus 0.0199 divided by 0.10492. If you inverse it, theta m tan inverse into this value, you will get theta value will be, theta m will be 10.75. Now, next part is very important here. After completion of this one, go for, now it lies in which quadrant it is. We have to find out it lies in which quadrant. It lies in fourth quadrant. Therefore, theta m is nothing but 360 minus 10.75. The answer will be 349.24 degree. This is the answer. Then how it is obtained? Why we have taken this is a fourth quadrant? Because here all are positives here. Here you can write as sine 180 minus theta is equal to sine theta in this quadrant, and cos 180 minus theta minus cos theta. In this quadrant, you have to write sine 180 plus theta minus sine theta, cos 180 plus theta minus cos theta. In this quadrant, sine 360 minus theta is nothing but minus sine theta, and cos 360 minus theta is nothing but cos theta. Now, as per this data, sine and cos terms are there. The sine term is negative here and cos term is positive. Therefore, it lies in the sine term is negative here, the cos term is positive here in the fourth quadrant. Therefore, we have to go for 360 minus theta. Sometime the theta value will minus, the minus will be obtained here. Just neglect minus sign. Don't go for making the plus here. You have to write as a minus only. Only the answer will be obtained here. Okay, this is the basic thing you have to understand. After completion of this one, just put this value, put the above value in equation 2, you will get mm is equal to 10.66 kg. Now we are resolving the forces horizontally and vertically. Resolving the forces horizontally and vertically. Summation of H is equal to m r cos theta. Now go for this table. In this table, this is the force, this is the table of the force, this is the table of the force and theta. What is force? M into R. Write it here. We will get the answers directly. What is M? 0.48 cos 0 plus 0.05 ml cos theta L plus 0.5 cos 60 plus 1.08 cos 135 plus 0.05 mm and mm into cos theta m, because theta m and mm are already obtained here. Substitute that value, you will get the value for this one, plus 0.45 cos 270. Okay, now in the place of mm and theta m, the all values are obtained here. Substitute here, you will get the values. In the place of this one, you have to write as 10.66, and the place of theta, you have to write as 349.24. You will get the value of this. Now the value will be 0.05 ml cos theta l plus 0.4899 is equal to 0. Bring this that side, ml cos theta l minus 0.4899. This is equation 3. Similarly, resolving the forces vertically, instead of cos, you have to write as a sine. Instead of cos, you have to write as a sine, or directly substitute it with the help of a calculator. You will get the answer sine 0 plus 0.05 ml sine theta L plus 0.5 sine 60 plus 1.08 sine 135 plus 0.05. Value of mm will be sine 349.24, I'm writing directly, into cos, I made a mistake here, 0.05 into 10.66 into sine 349.24 plus 0.45 sine 270 is equal to 0. Answer will be 0.05 ml sine theta L sine theta L plus 0.6471 is equal to 0. Bring this side, 0.05 ml sine theta L minus 0.6471, equation 4. Divide 4 divided by 3, you will get 0.05 ml sine theta L divided by 0.05 ml cos theta L is nothing but minus 0.6471 divided by 0.4899. Everything will cancel. Tan theta L, and this answer. Go for theta L into inverse into this one, you will get the answer as 52.87. Now here the 52, which coordinate it lies? It lies in, now as per this one, it lies what? It's minus sine theta and minus cos theta. It lies in third quadrant. Therefore, it should be 180 plus theta. It lies in third quadrant. Therefore, the theta value will be, theta L will be 180 plus 52.87. The answer will for this one is nothing but 2.87 degree. Once you get this value, substitute in equation 4. Once you get this value, theta is nothing 180 plus 52 as per this diagram. 52 because it lies in third quadrant. Next, after getting this value, substitute in 4 equation, you will get ml value as 16.23 kg. That's it. The analytical method is simple and more effective. Just you have to understand this concept. This concept plays a very important role. Okay. I am Santosh Gayankar. Thank you very much.